ladies and gentlemen, Miss Joan Crawford.
I'd like to tell you how excited and grateful I am that you could take the time out of your busy lives to be with me here today. Never show fear, only trust.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful.
Go placidly, amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even the dull and ignorant. They too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. We grow in spirit and wisdom. Some don't. I just love people and everyone I've ever worked with, really. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter, for always there will be greater or lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career, however humble. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. This is blue. Blue. The world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection, neither be cynical about love, for in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is perennial as the grass. This is green, green. Take kindly the counsel of the years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth.
With a man over twice your age, now get out of here!
Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune. But do not distress yourself with imaginings, because many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe. Because everything I have in this world has many, many insecurities. The little cripple loves evil things. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here, and whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should.
Nearly everyone accepts the Darwinian proposition that man's physical form evolved from lower animals. It is the consensus of all educated belief.
No doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God.
No one has ever done me justice, beginning with God.
Be at peace with God. Whatever you conceive him to be, and whatever your labors and aspirations in the noisy confusions of life. Keep peace with your own soul. With all of its sham and drudgery and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be careful. Strive to be happy. And this was found in Old St. Paul's Church, Baltimore, dated 1692. The noisy confusions of life.
This is Joan Crawford.
That's not so far-fetched. Just take a look in the mirror. It's our sacred as well as scientific duty to study this creature with complete dedication.
Your taste is sickening.
This is Joan Crawford.
Can you come up with a better explanation? I can only give you an hypothesis.
My abiding concern and my singular preoccupation is myself.
It's unthinkable, unbelievable.
What?
I think we should clarify the history of man's origin.
You will be gone soon, and I'll be glad!
That's wonderful.
I despise you!
That's wonderful, Trog.
Why don't you die?
You've conveniently forgotten Deuteronomy, the second commandment. Thou shalt not kill. I want you to give me the child. I implore you to let me go back with my hypo gun.
What?
Yes.
No. No.
Yes.
Being a two-faced woman.
You idiots! You were given strict instructions not to use flashlights.
Remember, we're dealing with a backward child.
Get me my hypo gun quickly. What do you think about pot?
I wish to God. I wish to God.
Adrian. Edith Head, Helen Rose, Jean-Louis, Mr. Spencer Tracy, Helen Hayes, the Gregory Pecks, the Frank Sinatras, Rosalind Russell, Robert Montgomery, Fred Astaire, Betty Davis, Baby Jane, the little cripple lady, and everyone I've ever worked with, really.
What do you think about pot?
The little cripple lady has to yell every morning. This woman is dangerous. The little cripple lady is dangerous. Joanne Woodward's mother called her the little cripple lady. I don't think anybody could have been better than the little cripple lady. The little cripple lady was married to the boss and I was just an actress. That's the little cripple lady. I received a call from the little cripple lady. I couldn't get through to the little cripple lady. I really don't know little cripple lady.